But there's something I always wanted to share with our people in Juma, and I wish that this could be embedded in our hearts. Do you know it is sunnah, while all of you have on mask, do you know it is sunnah to look at the khatib when the khutbah is going on? Not look at your toes and your knees and the ground and the mat. That's some kind of coolie mentality, Dihat village mentality. I don't know where that mentality came from. I don't know who invented that practice. The sunnah, and why I need to say that today, because you have on mask, I can't see your lips, I can't see your nose, I can't see your face, I don't even know what's the reaction. So it came to my mind of the sunnah. You see, brother, Sheikh, didn't this teach you guys that in Jamaat? The guys, do you know it is a sunnah? A lot of people sit and give khutbah. It is sunnah to stand and give khutbah. So when you see people who sit and give khutbah, it's probably they got a leg problem or they got a health problem. So Allah make it easy for them. But remember this, as we're here, it's Juma. COVID-19 barakat brings those hadith memories to mind. It is sunnah to stand. You go places and people tell you, sit, don't follow these stupid people. It is sunnah to stand and give a sermon. Especially a Juma sermon. I see people sit and give a bayan. Where they invented that from, that's a Dihat Indian mentality. You guys got that? It's not sunnah. Go read the sunnah. It is sunnah to stand and give a message. Unless you're sick. And it is sunnah that the people who are listening must look at the khatib. So much so in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and I'm cutting the khutbah of what we want to be talking about and continue inshallah. There were no parada between the men and the ladies. And the ladies used to look on, so they will concentrate. Oh yes, yes. Go check it out in hadith. I always say, Bismillah, bi'idhnillah, don't believe what I say. Go verify. It is sunnah to look at the khatib. That's a sunnah. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam on Eid day, on some occasions, he would go over on the ladies' side, even though they're there and there were no walls, but he will go in front of them and give them another message to make sure that they looked and they understand and they absorb. That's why here in Darul Uloom, and many are masajid now, but we have been doing this many decades ago. Many what? Decades ago. That we always had a television monitor on the ladies' side so they could see the khatib. Not a matter they could see me, it's not me, it's whoever is given the bayan. It is sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam to have eye contact with the people you're talking to. It is considered disrespect for the person who is given the khutbah, the person, the khatib, not to have eye contact with the audience. That's why it was sunnah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will move left or right and watch his people. There are some khatib, they move left or right, but they don't look at the people. See? Which is not right. They practice the sunnah left. All right, but you're supposed to try to get eye contact with your audience. That's the sunnah. And similarly, the audience is supposed to have eye contact with the person who is given the bayan, the reminder, the khutbah, etc. So I want this bi'idhnillah to be a reminder for all our viewers out there on Al Hikmah TV, YouTube, Facebook, and our Muslims. Because a lot of masajids I go to in America, and I see a lot of people during khutbah, they bend their heads. I don't know, what are you ashamed for? Kis baat se sharam hai bhai? What are you ashamed of? Coming for Juma? What are you bending your head for? That's not modesty. It's not modesty, it's stupidity. This is a Dihat mentality, a village mentality that has been practiced on, that everybody bend their head. And then shaitan taps you on your head and you fall asleep. It says, so ja bacha, so ja beta. And shaitan rubs your head and next thing you fall asleep. So you got to set up yourself to look at the khutbah. the person giving the khutbah, the khatib.